Senator Moore. Senator Abetz.
Thank you, Mr. President. Let's just be very clear about one issue here. What this government is seeking to do is to have the carbon tax repealed. That was the bipartisan position of Prime Minister Gillard and Leader of the Opposition, Mr. Abbott, at the 2010 election. Then in 2013, or we were promised there would be no carbon tax in 2010. Then in 2013, Prime Minister Rudd and Leader of the Opposition, Mr. Abbott, were once again on a unity ticket, and I have Exhibit A here, a Labor Party brochure authorised by George Wright, in which he tells us Kevin Rudd and Labor have removed the carbon tax. They have removed the carbon tax. So what on earth is my good friend Senator Moore, recently re-sworn as a representative of the people of Queensland, having been elected on the policy of removing the carbon tax, and her colleagues before her having been elected on a policy of never having a carbon tax, is now standing here seeking to frustrate the will of the Australian people? I don't think anybody could argue with a proposition that the carbon tax was one of the key issues at the last election. And the reason the Australian people wanted to see the back end of the carbon tax was because they knew it was impacting on their cost of living. $550 for the average household in Australia each and every year. And courtesy of the Green Labor majority that used to preside in this place, the carbon tax ratcheted up yet again on the 1st of July to increase that impost on Australian families even further. And if the cost of living impost wasn't bad enough, we know its destruction in relation to jobs. The carbon tax is a blot on the economic landscape of our nation. It attacks the cost of living of families, and it is destroying jobs as we speak. And we all know the example of Coogee Chemicals that wanted to set up in Australia but decided to set up in China instead. $1 billion worth of infrastructure capital investment, 150 jobs as an ongoing concern, replacing imports. And where did they have to set up ultimately? In China, simply because of the carbon tax. And you know what they do in China? They will be emitting more greenhouse gases in their production than they did in a pre-carbon tax environment in Australia. And that is where you see the absolute perverse environmental outcome of the carbon tax. Not only does it destroy Australia's economy and the cost of living, it actually ensures that clean production companies in Australia have to move offshore to countries where they do not have as strong an environmental regime as they do in Australia.
This is the classic
lose-lose-lose scenario that was inflicted upon the Australian people by the Australian Greens and the Labor Party in that marriage that they undertook with Senator Bob Brown and Ms. Prime Minister Gillard. Now, Mr. President, I don't know what the Labor Party interjections in particular are about, because I refer to this brochure again. Kevin Rudd and Labor removed the carbon tax. If we were to believe the very policy on which Senator Moore got herself re-elected to this place, that the carbon tax had been removed, sorry, what are these bills doing here? The carbon tax, we are agreed, still has to be removed. It is still on the legislative books, is it not? And we as an opposition said to the Australian people, if you elect us on the 7th of September last year, we will have as the first item of business in the new parliament the repeal of the carbon tax. And we lived up to that promise, and Prime Minister Abbott introduced the repeal of the carbon tax as the very first item of business in the new parliament. So it is of no surprise, It should be of no surprise
order
to those
left.
Officer
order.
That we, as the very first item of business in this new Senate, would seek to ensure the repeal of the carbon tax.
Order on my
and
right.
So, Mr President, can I simply say to those opposite, you had your fun last month. Yes, the dead hand of the old Senate reached out and attempted to control that which will happen in the new Senate. And that is why the motions were moved to seek to delay the will of the Australian people. And look, I've been asked, is this a measure that is frustrating the government? Can I say more importantly, this measure, or the motion moved by those opposite last month, was frustrating the Australian people. It's frustrating the Australian economy. It is frustrating the world's environment to boot. And so, in every possible respect, Mr. President, in every possible respect, and Senator Cameron says, what did you say? Can I ask you, Senator Cameron, what did you say when you sought re-election, you yourself, that the carbon tax has been removed on Labor Party-funded brochures? Chances are even your own union funded this. Even your own union may well have funded this brochure. So, Mr. President, the fact that we are seeking to put this up as the first item should be of surprise to nobody. We said we would do so if we were elected. The Labor-Green Senate majority frustrated us in that endeavour. We now have a new Senate more reflective of the will of the Australian people, generally on the 7th of September, taking into account the quirks of Western Australia. But that aside, Mr. President, we do have a situation where we as a government want to introduce this legislation as a matter of absolute urgency to get this blot off our economic landscape. And people quite rightly are concerned about their cost of living. Today the Senate has the opportunity.
Order, Senator Cameron.
So why did you campaign to abolish the carbon tax, not only in 2010 but 2013 as well? But of course, as I've already pointed out to Senator Cameron, he who will interject but never listen, that the carbon tax applying in Australia is in fact perverse in relation to the world's environment. Europe discovered that themselves. When they closed down their relatively clean aluminium smelters, only to see them pop up again in Africa and elsewhere, where the environmental regimes were not half as good as they were in their pre-existing foundries, etc., and smelters in Europe. As a result, the world's environment was worse off. The same is happening in relation to Australia. Everybody that has followed this debate, and with great respect to Senator Moore, it's not as though this is a debate that's fallen out of the sky just today. I think it's been around for a number of years, very strongly for a number of years, and in fact so strong was the sentiment in the Australian community that Labor promised no carbon tax in 2010, and they promised that absolutely. And then when they realised the vehemence with which the Australian people despised the carbon tax because it was impacting on their cost of living, it was destroying their jobs and having a perverse outcome on the environment, the Labor Party rushed around at the 2013 election to say, no, nothing to see here, nothing to see here. We've already removed the carbon tax. But of course, we know that the carbon tax has not been removed. Just as much as the Australian people were misled before the 2010 election that there would be no carbon tax, so they were misled by the Australian Labor Party in 2013 about the fact, as they asserted, the assertion that the carbon tax had already been removed. Mr. President, the simple fact that we have to introduce this swathe of bills, some nine of them, indicates that the carbon tax, regrettably, is still alive and well. And each day that this carbon tax continues, it will continue to have an impost on the cost of living of every single Australian will continue to destroy jobs, especially in the manufacturing sector, Senator Cameron, which you know, and it continues, the perverse outcome on the environment. So, Mr. President, we as a government are determined to—
Mr. President,
Senator Cameron, always willing to interject, never willing to listen. That is his want, and the new senators will soon— learn that that is his style, and a very ugly style it is, if I might say. But, Mr. President, we as a government will seek to prosecute those issues on which we were elected, and in particular this impost on the economy, which we believe was brought to us as a result of that marriage between the Australian Labor Party and the Australian Greens, something which former Senator Mark Bishop had words to say, quite rightly, no longer with us, regrettably, but I'm sure ably replaced by the new Senator Jay Bullock, and I wish him well. But, Mr. President, can I conclude my remarks by saying that we as a government are anxious to remove this impost for the Australian people, noting that in its removal we will be delivering on the promises made by Ms. Gillard and Mr. Abbott in 2010, and also Mr. Rudd and Mr. Abbott in 2013.